Good morning. Oh, there you go. There you go. All right, guys. So just woke up. It's nearly 8:10. So I got a little bit more sleep than I did the other night. Well, last night. Yeah, the other night. And yeah, I've noticed I've been saying a lot in this video. So today, it seems like it's nice and sunny outside, so I'll definitely be going outside to get some footage. And he did that. That little bastard. To be honest, I shouldn't really antagonise him. So I'm going to have some breakfast, probably watch some YouTube for a little bit. And then, well, actually, I might watch the animated film with my breakfast. This film that I'm going to be watching, I just saw it on the DVD shelf here in Genie's collection. So I'm not too sure what to expect from it. It's a film that I've been interested in checking out, so it should be okay. If it's bad, who cares? I can get more footage edited and hopefully get the first part of this video actually finished and rendered and that sort of thing. So I shall see you when I have freshened up a little. Okay, I lied. I didn't freshen up at all. But who really cares? So, today's, well, the first film of the day, I should say, haven't woken up yet, folks, is going to be Horton Hears a Who, which is based on the work of, forgot his name, Dr. Seuss, who, you know, as a kid, where am I going with this? Yeah, I'm not expecting great things from this film. I could be pleasantly surprised. All I know is there's only one thing I truly need to give me the strength to get through what could be a very tedious film. I wonder what that could be. Leftover pizza. Cold. It's always got to be cold. Don't warm that shit up. Always helps. I think I'm ready to face. Alright, so it wasn't a bad film, but it wasn't exactly a great film. It wasn't the best animated film that I've ever seen, but it wasn't too bad, I suppose. Nicely animated, the characters are brought to life really nicely, interesting enough story. I could imagine kids really, really enjoying the cinematic adaptations of the works of Dr. Seuss. But yeah, I've seen much better. But right now, it's approaching 10:15. And yeah, I think I'm going to wait till like late afternoon, early evening, before I go out and film the city. Mainly because I am feeling so, so lazy. It's a typical Sunday. Really not that motivated. I'm really comfy at the moment. I'm making good progress with the films. Only got the last of the trilogy to watch, a flop, and the foreign film. So I'll probably space them out a lot more today, so I don't get them all watched. But I do have a couple of other film related things that I can do. I've got a couple of reviews that I need to write, so I might film a little bit of that. How thrilling! And yeah, I think right now I am probably just gonna kick back a little bit, get some of my YouTube Watch Later playlist watched. I'm not even hungry, not even snacky, just really, really lazy. Ha 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 ha.
What's wrong? Are you going to tell me?
Hungry? Hada? Are you hungry? No, don't sniff my legs. How hungry are you? Yeah, he gets a little bit agitated, let's put it that way, when he's hungry, even though he's not starving or anything like that. He just eats a bit too quickly, he eats a little bit too much, and yeah, he's just a very grumpy, agity, and fidgety little bugger when he wants his daddy to feed him.
Well, it's currently just approaching 20 past 11. It's going to be one of those days where I'm just going to be lazing around, I'm going to be unmotivated. It's going to be really fun for you guys. But yeah, I've got myself another coffee. Can't have too many coffees. Well, you probably can. Right now, I'm just looking through some supermarket. They always have special deals on and different themed weeks. Well, some of them do, and they forecast how much, what's going to be on sale for the upcoming week and so. So I'm just gonna, like an old woman, sit through these, and then I am going to work out what I want to eat for the rest of the week. Well, for the upcoming week, and do a little bit of a shopping list, pick some stuff up for when Jeannie comes back, and then probably after this to conclude a trilogy of absolutely exciting events, I'm probably going to do a little bit of hoovering, do the washing up, get that sort of stuff out the way. I'm one of those people who finds it really tedious when you let the washing up. Did I really say like? I hate it when the washing up builds up, so then you're washing the dishes for about 40 minutes. I can't wait till we're in a bigger apartment where we can have a dishwasher. That's going to be amazing. And yeah, so apologies about what today's going to bring, but I will be watching films, of course, and later this afternoon, I will be venturing outside to get a little bit of footage. So it should still be a hopefully interesting video. Anyway, I'm gonna cut this part short because I'm sure you're all foaming at the mouth with excitement.
That sure was thrilling. Sorted out a rough list of what I'm going to be eating over the coming week. Had a nice little read. Nothing, that makes you want to jump for joy that's going to be on sale over this next week or so. But yeah, still not completely, I don't know. I'm not down in a funk or anything like that. I'm just not motivated to get out of this bed, so I won't be doing the washing up, I won't be doing the hoovering for a little bit. I'll probably do that a little bit later to get me up and about, so then it'll inspire me to leave the apartment. But for now, I'm going to be watching the special features of Confessions of a Dog, which was, like I said, in yesterday's video, even though they'll probably be uploaded separately. Basically, it was a great film, and I want to know a little bit more about the production of it. I'm not too sure what special features are on the disc, but it should be interesting nonetheless. And then after I've done that, I am going to watch the final film from the Milieu trilogy, which is The Boss. So looking forward to watching that one. And then I think after that, I've pretty much just got The Flop and the foreign film to watch. So I think The Flop, because I've looked through all of my DVDs and none of them, because they're like cheap exploitation flicks, they were probably never really at the box office anyway, so they couldn't technically flop. So I'm probably gonna have to stream a film online. I've got a good idea of a film that I'd like to watch. It's a cheap actioner. But from what I've seen of it, it's shot nicely, but it didn't do well at all at the box office. So that should be fun. I'll probably end up finishing on that one because it's going to be more of a silly, just leave your brain at the door sort of affair. And the foreign film I'm probably going to watch this evening because I'd rather space them out than just watch all the films now because then I'll have nothing to talk about or film. I know everyone watching this video does not want that. They want my thrilling life to be documented on camera. I'm probably going to finish the Pepsi. Drank way too much fizzy drinks over this past like few days. That's the thing, when I'm left in the apartment on my own, I just buy absolute shit. I eat. I consider good, but in terms of like health benefits, hardly any vegetables, just fatty stuff. I think today I'm probably going to do myself some mince and potatoes with a little bit of carrot and onion as well. So there's two of my five a day. Yeah, I'm dragging on this little segment, aren't I? Hope you're enjoying this video so far, guys, and I shall see you in a bit. I got finished watching the extras on Confessions of a Dog. Quite a good selection of extras. It's got like a making of, interviews, a panel discussion, a trailer, as well as trailers for other Third Windows films releases. And it just occurred to me that it's Easter Sunday, the day that I'm recording this one. So I hope yourselves and your families, and if you've got children, hope they're having a nice day. I know you'll get like atheists or fellow atheists like bitching, oh, well, Easter actually means blah, 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 blah. Who cares if it's pretty much like a bullshit, seasonal thing or a celebration? Who cares? As long as the kids enjoy it, fair enough. Plus, it gives you an excuse to get the family together, have a little bit of a, binge on food. I myself am having a hoppy Easter. See what I did there? The cat is even more lazy than I am right now, which is always good. So I think I'm gonna do a little bit of housework and then probably get ready, head out. It's just approaching 1 o'clock in the afternoon. It's probably gonna be a little bit packed in the city with families probably going for meals and that sort of thing. I don't know. It could be empty. Everyone could be at home having like meals, doing home cooked stuff and having Easter egg hunts and that sort of thing. I might buy myself some Easter. I don't need any more sweets. I'm not too sure what you'll be seeing after this little clip. I'm gonna head off, get a little bit of housework done, and then hopefully get some nice footage outside. I'm just about to start getting ready because I think I'm going to head out now, even though it's only 5 to 2. It feels like it's like 5 or 6 o'clock in the evening. That's the thing about when you get up early. It's just amazing how long the day lasts. And you know what? Why don't I make the most of it? I can get a few more hours potentially recording some footage. I don't know if I've got toothpaste around my mouth. I've only just brushed my teeth. So, yeah, I'm also potentially picking some stuff up from the supermarket that's usually open on Sundays, but being the fact that it is Easter Sunday today, I'm not too sure if it will be open. I don't need anything vital, but I thought I'd do myself a potato salad, mainly because we've got loads of potatoes left and if I have a potato salad, I can make enough for a couple of days, or at least like lunch tomorrow. And I'm just proper in the mood for a nice flavour some potato salad. I've got everything except something creamy. There was yogurt in there, but like the expiration date was the 28th of February, and I'm pretty damn sure we only bought that like a couple of weeks ago. What date is it today? I've actually forgotten the actual date. It's the 27th today. So that's like pretty much a month and a week after its expiration date. Now, I'm not a person who lives and dies by an expiration date, but when it says it's expired a month, well, longer than a month earlier, and the fact that you bought it like just a couple of weeks ago, yeah, I didn't want to really trust that. I'm gonna have to get like a little pot of sour cream or something like that, maybe another tub of yogurt. But if not, if it's not open, I've got plenty of food. I've still got chicken, I've got sausages, I've got mince, I've got ramen noodles, I've got loads of bread, I've got all sorts, so it's not vital. But I was thinking of picking up some like coffee and some fruit tea, because we drink fruit tea instead of drinking like Coca-Cola or fizzy water, which I don't mind fizzy water every now and then, but Jesus Christ, do I get gassy, and you do not want to be around me when I'm gassy, trust me. Just a few odds and ends, just to save me a trip during the week. But, yeah. So, I'm just updating my MP3 player, which is my old iPhone. It's all battered up. And that's, like, at about 20% battery. Plus, to get myself in the mood and to be caught up in the moment, I'm actually putting all my Italian film soundtracks on there. And I find music, I adore film, don't get me wrong, I live and breathe film. But one of the things that inspires me and just fuels my creativity and makes that mood just perfect and helps that creative process is music. So I could end up getting like overwhelmed by the tension or the sense of foreboding in some of the music, and I'll be like, oh, I'm gonna have to listen to the Stranglers now. Yeah, it's only 2 o'clock, but you know what? I can go outside, show the city, and hopefully create a nice little giallo-esque montage. And yes, I will be getting changed because I've wore this t-shirt for like the last couple of days. It doesn't seem... it's a bit gloomy outside. It's not sunny, but it doesn't look like it's gonna rain. But now in my luck, pretty much as soon as I get to the main area where I want to film, it's going to absolutely piss down. But we shall see, ladies and gentlemen. And I hope whatever I manage to put together, it will be quite nice. Anyway, thank you for your patience on day 2 of my thrilling 24-hour movie marathon. And yeah, I'm just waffling on now. So I shall see you in a bit. I've only just realised that I forgot to put the clock forward, so it's actually about 3:02. So, yeah, not too late, but, yeah. Peter is a dum-dum. While I'm waiting for my iPhone to be charged up, I actually got some posts yesterday and I forgot to show it. Well, I didn't. I filmed a couple of things, but I wasn't happy with what I was saying in the video, so... in a humph, I deleted it. Basically got a couple of review discs sent to me from Arrow, which is awesome. I appreciate that companies are, you know, sending me review titles. And of course, the train has to go past as I'm talking. But I always request DVD versions of the releases because I don't have a Blu-ray player and I don't actually aspire to upgrade to Blu-ray because I'm fine with DVD. It saves me having to buy a new player, it saves me having to replace my DVDs, and yeah, I've had Blu-ray in the past. I used to watch Blu-rays on my PS3, but that broke like 2 years ago, and I sold my Blu-ray collection. Made quite good profit from it, actually. Since then, I've never really looked back. But I was really excited for these releases that they were sending me because they're two giallos and I'm a massive fan of the giallo. And of course this fits in perfectly with what I'm going to be doing this afternoon. But unfortunately they sent me the Blu-ray versions. And the films are Death Walks at Midnight and Death Walks on High Heels. I can't remember the director's name, but they're two of his films and they've released a double pack. It's a really nice looking release actually. But I can't play these, and I don't know whether I should get in touch with them and ask for replacements, because I don't have to put, you know, put them through the hassle of sending me more stuff and then me sending the titles back. So I might just keep hold of them or potentially trade them on at a future date. I just wanted to talk about that. But it's actually given me a good reason to show you a really interesting place here in the apartment complex. And basically, I'm going to be taking this bubble envelope that it was sent in downstairs, because I've got like a suitcase full of like packing materials. I haven't bought like bubble envelopes or bubble wrap for about 2 years because I recycle all the packaging material. It's so cost effective, it makes perfect sense. If it's not ripped, if it's still usable, use it. I always pack really good anyway, not to toot my own horn. So I thought I'd show you the basement of the apartment building because it's a creepy place. And then hopefully by the time I've done that, my iPhone will be ready and I can head off into the city and show you the area. Brace yourselves, because this is a creepy-assed place. For me anyway. Probably at this point thinking, what's the big deal? It's well lit for the most part, and once it is lit, it's nice and bright, you can see what you're doing. Well, there's one thing about this place, and at night time it's creepy in general, but the lights don't actually stay on permanently. They're on like a weird timer. So you'll be just like going about your business. I mean, I'm at that point now where if I know I'm doing like a lot of stuff in the, because it's like basically storage for all the tenants, like most apartment complexes, I'd imagine. So if I know that I'm going to be down here for like more than 5 minutes, I will like literally every 30 seconds come out and press the light switch so the light stays on, because it's so damn creepy and unsettling when you're going about your business and then all of a sudden like the lights turn off. You know, it's like, I don't know. There's just something really strange about this little area. I mean, thankfully, at this point, it's still really bright outside. But if you're in this situation, like early in the morning or late at the evening, it's going to be really damn creepy. And I've actually shot like a short film down here, like on my own. Just me. I've shot it myself, I've even acted in it. It was just like a little 2 minute artsy thing. I'm not sure where I've uploaded it. If it's on YouTube, I'll put the link down below. But yeah, a really, really interesting little place. And then you've got like some people's like areas where they've like got sheets over the main area, so you can't see what's in there. So you're like, your mind goes to weird places. Well, mine does anyway. But yeah, there's just something really, really creepy about this place. And knowing my luck, when I go upstairs to edit it, there'll be like a figure in the background as I'm talking and I've not realised it. But yeah, it's a really, really interesting little place. And oh my god. Don't worry, I was only acting. It's still a fucking creepy place though. Yeah, I'm out of breath just walking up a couple of flights of stairs. Like I said, creepy little place. I mean, I'm somewhat used to it now, so it doesn't like unsettle me as much as it used to. But every now and then when I'm down there and I have these like irrational ideas and moments of fear, because I don't believe in ghosts, I don't believe in monsters, I don't believe in the paranormal, I don't believe in forces beyond our control, but I sometimes get like these pictures or ideas in my head and it will like freak me out for ages. The amount of times that's happened down there is unbelievable. So anyway, I'm pretty much about ready now. I'm just gonna put this footage onto the MacBook so then I can, you know, have a lot of memory to film outside. And I shall see you when I come back from my little outing. Enjoy the following montage. Thank you. Well, I'm back, and I won't lie, I know already that I got so much, like, just small segments of footage, that it's going to be a fucking bitch to put that together in a semi-coherent way. So you motherfuckers better appreciate it. Well, I think you will seriously agree that the city that I'm living in right now is absolutely beautiful. And it's got those, like, Italian vibes that I really, really love about it. It's a city that would be an absolutely perfect backdrop to an Italian giallo. I even have a kind of screenplay of a giallo that I'd love to film here in Regensburg. Maybe one day that could happen. It could be a little short. You never know. But yeah, absolutely gorgeous outside. It does look a bit gloomy, but it's not too cold, not too warm. I was just there with my hoodie on, which is always nice. I do love spring. And I tried to get as much footage as I could, even though I got a lot of weird looks from people, which is completely understandable. Thankfully, the supermarket, well, it's a small little thing attached to a train station, was open. So I was able to get some yogurt for my potato salad and picked up a bit of coffee, because you can never have too much coffee. I'll probably have a coffee actually in a little bit. Right now I'm just in the process of preparing my potato salad, and no, I won't be using all those potatoes as much as I'd love to. The great thing about potato salad, it's one of my favorite things, but it's one of those things that you cannot really gorge yourself on because you'll feel so stuffed and bloated. So I'm gonna have some potatoes in it, obviously, a couple of spring onions, some herbs, some pickles, and the brine from the pickles adds a nice citrusy, not citrusy, but like sourness to them. A little piece of advice that I picked up from my many years of professional cooking. If you've got a small potato, what you should do is, because you don't really need to clean potatoes if you're going to be boiling them and then peeling them. What you do is, well, what I do is I score in the middle. So then, theoretically, when it's boiled and the skin has separated, you can literally just pull it apart like that. You can literally pull the skin off. Of course, when you've got bigger potatoes like that, you just half them and you can pull it off anyway. But yeah, I'm going to put a couple of eggs in there as well, boil them up with the potatoes. And it's going to be damn nice because I do love a potato salad. Anyway, I'm going to get this done. Going to get all that footage uploaded to my MacBook. Not going to be doing too much editing today because I've got a week of having the apartment to myself after this, so I can get it done then. And yeah, the next film I'll be watching will be the final film in the Milieu trilogy from Fernando de Leo, the boss. So I'm going to really enjoy that with a nice beer and potato salad. I'm living the life. I have no idea what that was. The Boss has just finished, and again, an absolutely fantastic little film. But just like Caliber 9, I actually remember it differently. I think this could have been my favourite when I first watched it. But it's actually, not in a bad way, it's my least favourite of the trilogy. It starts off with one of the most insane and absolutely fantastic pre-opening credit sequences of all time. I won't ruin it, just in case you've not seen it. Absolutely phenomenal stuff. But I don't know, it drags in some parts. But you've got Henry Silver in there, Richard Conte, and there's almost like The Godfather. There's a scene where they hit a lot of people at once, and then it's put to music and it shows them, and it's like edited together really nicely. So a lot of these films obviously do capitalize and sometimes even rip off, you know, the bigger American films. I mean, that's the Italian film industry pretty much built on those principles. But I completely forgotten that at the end of this film, It says to be continued. And I can't remember if I even know what the film is that is supposed to follow on from this. Even if it exists, I'm gonna have to look it up on like Fernando de Leo's IMDb. But I'm not even sure if there is a film that carries on the story. And I was like, what? It just like ends. And it says like continua on the screen. So I'm not too sure if it does, if there is a film that follows the story. I know there's a couple of films that Henry Silva did with Fernando de Leo after his involvement in the Milieu trilogy, so maybe it does follow on. Really good film, really satisfying trilogy of films, full of action, misogyny, they're mean-spirited, they're like morality tales, all that sort of thing, great action violence, and all with fantastic scores, shot brilliantly, just endless fun from start to finish. So, I've got two more films to watch. It's now currently, I think, about 8:45 in the evening. Now, what am I saying? 25 past 8. I can't read the time. The clocks, when I put the clock forward, I didn't put the clock up properly, so I've just become an idiot. Well, I was an idiot anyway. So now I'm just going to do myself a cup of tea. Going to do a tiny bit more editing of some of the footage I've already recorded. I was going to do a finish off a written review that I'd started before the challenge, but can't really be bothered, and I haven't hoovered. So yeah, I'm in bed and I'm not getting tired. I'm just like getting really comfortable. So it's good that this is happening now and not like at the start of the day, even though I didn't really even start until the afternoon. Yeah, I'm not sure how this part's going to turn out, but I'm sure I can put something together. So I'm going to have a cup of tea, get a bit of editing done, and then I'm going to be watching the foreign film, even though nearly all the films I've watched have been foreign. That's the way it go, I suppose. And yeah, see you guys in a bit. Boom in the shot, boom in the shot. I'm proper funny, me. But yeah, anyway, the penultimate film, ladies and gentlemen, is my choice for foreign film. A film called Mamiya, which stars the absolutely phenomenal Isabelle Huppert. Now, from what I can gather, because I don't have the case with me and I've not looked it up before watching it, the reason why I was drawn to this film in the first place was because it's dealing with a somewhat controversial subject. In fact, it is a very controversial subject from what I remember. And Isabelle Huppert plays as, I think she's either a mother or a stepmother, and she falls in love with her son slash stepson. I could have got it completely wrong, but I'd heard good things about it, and I saw it in FOP for dirt cheap. So I picked it up, and again, I've had it in the collection for nearly 2 years. So I'm using Ryan's 24-hour movie marathon as a perfect opportunity to get it finally watched. So I'm really intrigued about this one. I do like films that tackle controversial subjects, and hopefully this one lives up to the hype and reputation, even though I don't think I've really even heard too many people talking about it. You know what I mean. Let's get the film watched.
Kind of destroyed my little selfie stick. No idea how that happened. It just literally shattered and it's just about staying on. I'm not sure if it'll actually keep the phone. Oh, and by the way, the guy is getting it on with his mummy.
It's now currently 11 minutes past 12, so I think I've technically got to the 24-hour mark. What I'm going to do is, after I've watched the final film, I'm going to tally up the runtime of all the films that I've watched. So I think I'm within the boundaries of it. But yeah, Mamma Mia, very strange little film. Very strange little film indeed. I wasn't expecting it to be as graphic as it was. Lots of masturbation in there. We've almost come full circle with Apple Cart, even though the circle is still carrying on because this isn't the end. But you know what I mean. Isabelle Huppert, I think that's how you pronounce the name. One of my favourite actresses, one of the most beautiful women in the world, and I still don't know how to pronounce her second name. Phenomenal actress, and I really liked her in this one. Although she could have been in it a bit longer, or a bit more, I should say. It was more about her son. And yeah, strange film. Basically, the basic story is the son comes home from like Catholic boarding school, and he's back with his mum and dad in the really nice villa on the, is it the Costa Rica where they are? I can't remember. I'll get to why I can't really remember too much of the film in a minute. He's got like this really nice holiday home with his mum and dad, and his dad's like seems really depressed, and he has to go back to France to business. And his dad dies in a car crash. So it's just him and his mum. And his mum almost like sexually liberates him. She introduces him to her friend, and she like just like tells him to express himself and all this sort of stuff. It's about sexual realization. He gets with different people, gets into a relationship, blah 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 blah. And yeah, not gonna spoil how it ends. I didn't see the end coming. But I don't know, it was the film that I would usually, really rant and rave about in a positive light. But I don't know, I felt slightly underwhelmed by this film. It seemed a little bit too long. Not sure how long the film actually was. I guess it was around the 2 hour mark, something like that. But it just really plodded in places. And even though there is graphic content and some really like left field stuff, it just didn't grip me as much as I wanted it to. But it's one of those films that it's a hard sell to a lot of people. Some people will not be able to sit through this. I think it's based on an unpublished book from a French writer about his, like, or I'm not too sure if it's about him because I'm not familiar with the writer's work. But the director and an interview like drew parallels with that writer, Bastille or something like that, not Bastille, and the Desaad, about how the people's misconceptions of these writers who 9 times out of 10 they've never actually read any of their work. So he sounds like an interesting writer, and it's based on one of his books about sexual fantasies, ancestral sexual fantasies. Yeah, it's a weird one. Would I recommend it? I'd say give it a go. You can pick it up really cheap on DVD back in the UK. The best thing about it for me is Isabelle Huppert. I don't usually buy into the whole like MILF thing, but there's just something about her. Even though she has been in some really, I don't know, somewhat trashy roles, she has this elegance and sophistication about her, and she seems to get better with age. This isn't one of my favourite Huppert performances, don't get me wrong, but it's still, she is the star of the show. But yeah, just give it a try if you ever stumble across it. It's not for everyone, I won't lie, but looks like I'm touching myself there. Taking influence from the film? No, just a really unfortunately placed hand, I assure you. Give it a go. I don't know if I'd rush out to watch it again anytime soon. I might revisit it at some point. And yeah, that was the penultimate film of the 24-hour film marathon. And it's, late. I'm starting to get a little bit tired. And the next film should be the perfect way to end this really enjoyable little event. I hope it's just been as enjoyable for me participating in it as it is for you actually watching it. So I'm gonna maybe get myself a snack, even though I've obliterated the potato salad. Got a cup of tea here as well, because I'm British, of course. So I'm gonna wind down. I have to watch it on the laptop with headphones because the laptop's really loud. So I'm having to stream it online. Anyway, let's cut this part short.
Well, I'm having to just hold my phone to record this one because that has become genuinely unstable now. But I've just very quickly totted up the running times. Well, they're just very basic running times. I'm going off like IMDb, so I'm not too sure how completely correct they are. So, what is the last film that I'll be watching? What's the flop? It's Sabotage, starring Arnold Schwarzenegger from 2014. And that would leave me with 14 hours and 22 minutes worth of films, which is quite substantial, I think you will agree. I'm all ready to watch this film. I hope it's at least entertaining in a stupid way. And I will see you after it's finished. Pirate, 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 pirate. I'm a pirate, pirate, pirate. What you are about to hear is quite possibly some of the best dialogue that I've ever heard in my life.
Scream at me.
Where's
you
the money?
Dumb fuck you. Look at you. You're fucking 48% body fat and you scrawny little bastard. Fuck you guys.
Well, Sabotage was an absolutely fantastic little action film. I was going into it expecting sort of like this young, dumb, and full of cum sort of action exploits where it was just mindless, immature, brash, loud. I mean, it was loud, it was a little bit obnoxious, but it had some weight to it, and I was really impressed with the actual action within the film. Brutal as hell, some absolutely fantastic effects, some fantastic kills. I think there was some CGI blood here and there, but that's, that's commonplace now in cinema in general. But yeah, written and, well, I think mainly written and directed by David Ayers, I think his name is. He wrote Training Day, and he's actually got quite a few good credits to his name. And this is more lowbrow to some of his other Hollywood films. I think he's even directing Suicide Squad, from what I can gather. And yeah, I really, really enjoyed the film. Is it a perfect action film? No. There's some really bad overacting. Schwarzenegger, fantastic in this role, but he has some of the most hilarious dialogue, as you will have seen. I don't know, it feels out of place him talking like that and like cracked. I mean, we know him from the 80s for cracking jokes and having one-liners, but he sort of felt like the old man trying to fit in the way he was like shit talking with his crew. And yeah, it didn't really take anything away from it. It all added to the experience, and I can't really think of any way to fault it. This is what I like when I get action films. I like action films that are just kind of entertain me, and it's got some twists and turns. Some of them you can see from, a mile away, but it's done really well. And I think this was actually the original cut, or the intended cut of the film was about 3 hours long and more of a thriller. I'd be interested to see if there is actually a version like that available. I'd happily pick this up on DVD and have it in my collection. I could happily watch it again. Some great performances from a lot of recognizable actors, and yeah, all in all, an absolutely fantastic way to end the 24-hour movie marathon. Right now, it's just about to approach 20 past 2 in the morning, so I'm going to do the usual stuff and hit the hay, maybe watch a couple of YouTube videos before I go to bed. And yeah, I'm going to be spending the next couple of days editing this final part together. But I've really enjoyed doing this, and I hope that you guys have enjoyed following this too. My video might not be as well thought out or executed as someone like Ryan's or Luke over at Razor Wire Reviews, who rarely goes all out, which I think is absolutely fantastic. But mine's a bit more humble, I suppose. But I hope that I've at least entertained you in both parts, and I'm so... what's the right word? For those of you who have watched up until this point, a massive, massive thank you. A big, 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 big shout out to Ryan Chataway for coming up with this concept. I think it's absolutely fantastic. I hope you're doing another one for Halloween. And if you're doing this next year, I'll definitely be doing it again. I don't know why I've missed out on it the past couple of times, because I've enjoyed it. I've enjoyed just filming myself, going about my business. I've been filming outside and going downstairs and showing you what I've been eating. I love that sort of thing. I love when you can see people being themselves and just showing you their lives on camera. And yeah, I've really enjoyed it. Watched some great films, some better than others. Very happy with my film selection. And there were some parts of this couple of videos that I maybe could have done a bit differently, and there were some ideas that I wish I'd have gone through with, but all in all, you know, I'm happy with what I've done. It's been an entertaining couple of days. It's really made my weekend, and it's Easter Monday tomorrow, so not really too much going on. So it gives me the perfect excuse to get the video edited, and hopefully... well, you will have seen it by now. Hopefully I can do something good with the footage from outside. So, anyway, I'm waffling on way, way too much. Check out Ryan Chataway down below in the description box. I'm sure you're already subscribed to him, but if not, do yourselves a favour. It's great to see fellow cinephiles on YouTube. And, yeah, hope you've enjoyed it. I am repeating myself now, so I'm going to cut this video off. How many times have I said that specific phrase? Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for following me. Thank you for sticking with me. And yeah, I shall see you in whatever the next video may be. See you guys later.
You want to say goodbye to all the people who've watched? Oh, no. Oh, okay then.
Ignorant little...